This is Nine News with Mark Burrows.
Good morning. A young family have been left shaken after they were forced to barricade themselves inside their attic during a home invasion in Sydney's inner west. Live now to Nine's Tiff Genders, who's at the Royal Prince Albert Hospital. Tiff, how are the family doing this morning?
Pretty cool, calm and collected, Mark, which is a surprise considering the nightmare they've been through. This is a holiday that this young family will not forget. Eddie Madden, his wife and their one-year-old daughter were in Sydney from Hong Kong for a family wedding. It was the last night of their trip when at about 3:30 this morning they woke to the sound of smashing glass at Eddie's elderly parents' home in Balmain. Now, when he ran down to see what the noise was, Eddie came face to face with a six-foot stranger. This man was apparently ranting and raving. He was also bleeding and allegedly told Eddie that he was armed with a gun. Now, there were moments of panic. Eddie screamed at his wife to get their daughter and his elderly parents and barricade themselves inside the attic. It is at that point that this alleged intruder has charged up the stairs with two knives that he grabbed from the kitchen drawer. He then barricaded himself in one of the bedrooms with the family's pet dog. Take a listen.
I think it took about an hour of sort of talking to him, and then they worked out that his family came along here. They called him and then they got him to come outside. And, you know, it all ended peacefully, but unfortunately my parents are quite elderly, so my mum had had some heart sort of palpitations, so they've taken her up to RPA.
Now, the grandmother is still in hospital here at Royal Prince Alfred Hospital, undergoing checks for those chest pains. The alleged intruder is also being treated here at RPA. He will have to undergo surgery for injuries he suffered when he allegedly smashed through the front door, and it's likely he'll have to undergo a psychiatric assessment. Mark?
A scary night indeed. Tiff, thank you. From humble local heroes to household names, more than 1,200 Australians from all backgrounds have been recognised in today's Queen's Birthday Honours List. More women than ever before have been honoured, also making the list, movie stars, sporting heroes. Jane Azzopardi has more.
We bought their albums, watched their movies, TV shows and stage productions. Now, these artists have joined hundreds of other notable Australians on the Queen's Birthday Honours List. Hugh Jackman receives the highest civilian honour, a Companion of the Order of Australia.
And I am just so grateful for the opportunities that I have received by being raised in Australia. The countless teachers, the mentors, the institutions that have supported me are immeasurable.
Our very own David Campbell recognised with a medal.
It's never something I would have expected to receive. You know, a Bogan boy from Adelaide with not much education, going into the arts, I didn't think it would do much, and so it's lovely.
Kevin Rudd has accepted an honour he declined several years ago while still Prime Minister. A record percentage of female recipients are honoured this year. Deborah Laurie smashed the glass ceiling in aviation. She took Ansett to court and won, becoming the first female pilot for a major Australian airline. 2018 Australian of the Year Professor Michelle Simmons is honoured as a role model in science education and quantum physics. And Rosie Batty, who has turned her own personal trauma into a force for good.
To think that I'm still being recognised, and it has been 5 years, so I feel very pleased, I think, that, pleased.
And Ita Buttrose, the new chair of the ABC.
I suppose I got an inkling that I might have been a bit of a role model at some point in my career, certainly when I was running the Women's Weekly, and I was one of the first working mothers.
In a country obsessed with sport, almost every code is represented. Former Wallabies captain Stephen Moore, basketball legend Luke Longley, former tennis world number one Frank Sedgman, Major League Baseball player Dave Nilsson, and rugby league legends Cameron Smith and Jonathan Thurston. And the man who delivered most of our sporting news for decades. But what is Channel 9 legend Ken Sutcliffe most proud of?
I survived 50 years in broadcasting and didn't get the sack. How about that?
A man's been attacked and shot as three robbers raided his home in Melbourne's Outer East. Live now to Sam Cucciara at Emerald. Sam, what injuries did he suffer?
Well, Mark, this father suffered a gunshot wound to his leg, but thankfully his injuries aren't life-threatening. Plenty of police are still on scene here this morning after this all unfolded at around 4:30. We're told that three men stormed their way into a home here in Emerald before opening fire on that 53-year-old man, shooting him in the leg. He's since been rushed to hospital where he's right now undergoing emergency treatment. There were two other people inside with him at the time, but thankfully they didn't suffer any physical injuries. As for the motive for this, that's something that still remains unclear this morning, although detectives do believe that this may have been a targeted attack. Those three intruders fled on foot up the street before jumping into a getaway car and vanishing. Concerningly, this is the latest flare-up of gun violence we've seen here in Melbourne, Mark. It's the third shooting in as many days.
Sam Kuchiara, live for us from Emerald, thank you. The government's tax cut plan has hit a snag with Pauline Hanson declaring she won't support them. Live to political reporter Jonathan Kersley. Jonathan, what she had to say.
Mark, Pauline Hanson has put a roadblock of sorts in the way of the government by saying she won't support the Coalition's $158 billion income tax cuts package in full. She says the money would be better spent elsewhere, like a coal-fired power station, in a bid to lower energy prices, or in the area of family violence law reform. But the One Nation leader has changed her mind previously, notably last year during the debate on company tax cuts, accused then of flip-flopping. But even without One Nation's backing, the government can get the tax cuts through the upper house. The magic number in the Senate is 39. The government has 35 senators. So even if the Labor and the Greens don't support government bills, the Coalition only needs the support of four crossbenchers to get legislation through. So say if the two Centre Alliance senators, Corey Bernardi and then Jackie Lammy, support, in this case, the income tax cuts package in its entirety, then it will pass. Senator Hanson, though, she has other priorities. Here's what she told Today.
We're talking about over $158 billion over the next few years. You know, I think there's more important issues out there that are of a concern to the Australian people. I want to see a coal-fired power station built in Australia to reduce electricity prices. And I want to see the Bradfield scheme to ensure water security in Australia.
Mark, this, though, is all part of the negotiation. A crossbench senator pushing her case for what she wants in return for supporting government legislation.
OK, Jonathan, thank you. A seven-year-old boy is fighting for life after being rescued from freezing conditions in waters off the Sunshine Coast in Queensland. Sophie Upcroft has the latest.
We have spoken to the hospital this morning and they have confirmed that young Julian is still in a critical condition and that he has been placed into an induced coma. Meanwhile, his father Mikey and his friend are being treated on the Sunshine Coast for hypothermia and they are in a stable condition this morning after their fishing trip took a terrible turn in the early hours of Sunday morning. At around 1:30 a.m. they issued a mayday call as their 5-metre boat began taking on water and sinking very quickly. We understand that Mikey and his friend actually held Julian out of the water for some 6 hours as they tread water themselves and clung to any floating debris that they could find. At around 8 a.m. another boat spotted the trio. Young Julian was winched to safety and the other two men were taken to shore by boat. Emergency services have told us that this could have been much worse as the conditions were extremely dangerous. The wind and the water were both very cold.
It's very fortunate that the three people were found when they were. They had been in the water for several hours and they're all very lucky.
We understand that nobody on board was wearing a life jacket and this will form part of an investigation as the search continues for the boat. But this morning, family and friends of young Julian are focusing their energy on hoping and praying that he can pull through.
Residents of a brand new apartment block in East London have been forced to flee when a massive blaze ravaged the building. 100 firefighters were called to battle the flames, which engulfed 6 floors of the complex. There had been concerns about the use of wood cladding on the construction prior to the fire. A crane has toppled and slammed into an apartment block in the United States, killing a woman and injuring at least 6 others, 2 of them critically. The crane had been buffeted by powerful winds in Dallas, Texas, just moments before the tragedy. The impact caused the collapse of several parts of the building, including residential areas and the garage. Five people have been injured in Germany after a 19th century ship collided with a container boat on a river in Hamburg. Luckily, rescue crews were nearby and were able to evacuate the 43 passengers quickly. Unfortunately, the schooner couldn't be saved. The ship had recently undergone a $2.5 million restoration. Well, Prince Philip will today celebrate his 98th birthday. The Duke of Edinburgh is the oldest male member of the British royal family and has been enjoying his retirement. The Prince retired from his duties in 2017, completing a total of 22,219 solo engagements since 1952.